Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
The metrics that we just discussed, what is your take on how long that curve will take?
Well, that's the question of the hour, Larry. We're definitely going in the right direction, but we're still in the high level of infections going on. The cases per 100,000 population, that's the number that Dr. R. Woody was talking about, or referring to anyway. It's somewhere in Chicago, about 150 cases per 100,000, which is good nationally. We are now at, she's talking about something 50 or less. So we got a long way to go. But we're talking like a month or so, I think.
Oh, good. All right. So let's talk about the fertility impact. A lot of people have been worried about these vaccines and their impact on fertility. But there's something, it's actually, you're okay with the vaccines, but there's something else people should worry about. Talk about that.
Yeah, so, you know, there's always issues. Fertility issues are, of course, very important to everybody,
right.
And they're very worried about this with the vaccine. So they have not seen anything with the vaccine in fertility, female or male. However, COVID has a very detrimental effect on men, on sperm counts and sperm function. That's been documented. It's very real. It presumably comes back after COVID is over, but the biggest impact is COVID itself on men.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. My teenage kids are vaccinated but not boosted. They recently tested COVID positive. How long do they need to wait before getting the booster? Is the booster still necessary?
Yeah, the booster is definitely still necessary. You wait 5 months after the second shot and you're feeling well and recovered from COVID.
Right. But how long after you recover from COVID can you get that booster? That's come up a couple of times.
As soon as you feel well.
Ah, okay. All right. Next question. My husband and I got our booster shot last August. Studies now show that it is now only 40% effective. Should we go get another booster?
No. 40% effective in terms of antibodies, but there's another whole part of the immune system that the vaccine does, and that holds up well. You take the booster when it gets approved.
All right. Next question. I recently read that the rapid tests only detect Omicron 30% of the cases. With this high false negative, why are we using them?
This number is a little bit off. It's slightly lower. But remember, all the rapid tests, or almost all of them, work best in symptomatic cases. When you're asymptomatic, there's a lot of negatives if you happen to be also positive.
Okay. Also, on the rapid test, if the pink line positive is dark, does that mean you have it worse than someone with a faint pink line?
No, it's strictly a binary thing. If you see any line, faint or dark pink, it's positive. It's just positive, negative.
Gotcha.
All right. How many times can I wear a KN95 mask before throwing it away?
They're designed for single use. However, it's impractical. When it gets dirty, either from sneezing or coughing into the mask, or it gets dirty from the outside, you should change it. You should probably change it somewhere at least once or twice a week, store it in a brown paper bag.
All right. Which masking scenario provides the best protection? N95, NIOS? Can you read the screen? Double masking, cloth and disposable. What's the best combo?
Okay, definitely number one here, button number one, the N95 NIOSH mask, National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health, is definitely the best. Double masking, either with cloths or just a couple of the blue masks, the surgical mask, is about 85% protective. So the 95 is definitely better, NIOSH.
All right.
NIOSH, sorry about that.
Here's another question. I am vaccinated, Johnson & Johnson and Moderna shots. I got the Omicron variant. What happens to my body when I am exposed to COVID-19 again? Will my body be able to fight it off, or could I get sick again?
Great question. We don't know the answer. Delta didn't protect anybody from Omicron. But we don't know if Omicron will protect people from the next variant. It depends what the next variant really looks like. But we call these kind of people hybrid immunity. They have it from the infection and from the vaccine, and that's better than either one alone.
All right, last question. In April 2020, we had to cancel a long-planned trip to Berlin and Paris. Now we would like to go at the end of April. We're both vaxxed and boosted. I'm concerned about contracting COVID and being quarantined on our trip. You think we should go in April or in September?
Well, I have to get my crystal ball out here, but I would bet on April, because I think this Omicron peak is going to be going down in North America and Europe. And by September, who knows what's going to happen? Remember what happened in last September.
In the fall, yeah. Okay, well, if you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Thanks, doctor.
Have a great weekend.